Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 2 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So last episode I talked a bit about what you will need to actually get started with the mod, pretty much involving things like the unrouted pipes, basic pipes, but also a couple of tools that you need like the Logistics Heads-Up Display Glasses and the Logistics Pipe Controller. So today I want to get into the basics of how you are able to sort items with logistics pipes in and around your base. So let's get started. Alright, so as you can see, I got myself a little demonstration here set up. Pretty much last episode I started with only this right here, but I built this around it pretty much to display what I want to tell you guys this episode. And of course, the more I continue into this series, the more I will be adding to this amazing, you know, contraption. So before I get started, I quickly want to mention that I put these signs here to demonstrate where I put basic pipes in my system, so you guys know pretty much where, you know, I have put them, because they don't really show up that good otherwise. Well, you know, these little dots right there, but I thought adding a sign makes it a little bit better of an indicator to you guys. So yeah, pretty cool. So first of all, I want to talk to you guys quickly about chassis pipes. Chassis pipes are pipes that on their own don't do anything. As you can see, they only hold a specific slot. The Mark 1 chassis pipe holds one slot. The Mark 2 that I got set up here can hold two slots. And then there's also the Mark 3 holding 3, 4 I believe holding 5, and the Mark 5 being able to hold 8 different modules. So that's pretty cool. So let's get started about actually talking about modules first then. Modules are pretty much things that you are able to put into chassis pipes that do a certain task. If I look up logistics pipes, you'll be able to see that there are a bunch of different modules out there. Item sink, extractor, electric buffer, bee analyzer, atomic aspects, crafting modules, so many different types of modules that you will be able to use, all with appropriate uses for them. But today I will be talking about the following. The extractor modules, being the Mark 1, 2 and 3. The quicksort module, I'm not sure where I got that somewhere. There we go, quicksort module. The provider module and corresponding provider logistics pipes. Item sync modules, mod-based item sync module, and a polymorphic item sync module. So, let's get started then. Okay, so before I actually do anything, let me quickly hook up the first two parts, which will be this one, which will be the main default route chest. If that doesn't say anything to you, don't worry yet. And the first line right here. So, let's just quickly demonstrate what these things do. So first of all, we got the quicksort module. The quicksort module is a module that, once placed in the logistics chassis pipe, we'll try to extract the items in the corresponding inventory and put it in a chest that already has the designated place for it. So if I will quickly show you guys right here, I got myself some logistics chassis pipe Mark II based on some polymorphic item sync modules. Polymorphic item sync modules basically mean that it will allow items that are already in the current inventory. So that means that if I have put one piece of wood in this chest, it will be able to send as much wood as can fit in this inventory to this actual inventory. But if it does not have any, it will just not be able to send any items to that. And then I will have a provider module into this, so I'll be able to request items later on, but I will not be using that for now. So I got that set up to all these three chests. Then on this side, I got myself a logistics chassis pipe Mark II, set up with a provider module again, and a normal item sync module. Basically, a normal item sync module allows you to set a default route, which is the place where items will be sent to when they don't have a dedicated spot anywhere on the system. So that's pretty cool, but it does have to be whitelisted for that. If you want to have a normal place that will be able to automatically extract items, but don't actually need to have at least one of them in there, you can use a normal basic pipe, just like so. Quickly connect this. Do it like so. And put this to the default route. Pretty cool. So, what you will be able to do is, like, well, let me just demonstrate. If I put the quicksort module in here, and I get myself some resources out, some wood, planks, yeah, some stone, dirt, and wood. If I would place some oak in here, you would see it will not be able to send it anywhere. Because, of course, it does not have a place to go because nothing is designated, either in the default pipe or the item sync module. That's the downside of the quicksort module. It has to have at least one of the item that you want to have sent in the appropriate inventory, which is, for basic sorting, not really something I would recommend when using... Yeah, just not a fan of the quicksort module. But what would happen if I actually get some wood out and put it in one of these polymorphic item sinks, which will, like I said, make it so that if there's any item in here, it will accept that same very item. I put one in there, and then it should realize, like, oh hey, I got a place where I'm actually able to send the wood. Then it will automatically send it to there. How cool is that? But of course, it won't send any other items to there, because if I would place dirt and stone... Nope, no can do. But, of course, what would happen if I would say, for example, put a piece of dirt in there, and a piece of stone in there, and put the wood back in here. You will see, like, it will send the dirt to this chest, the stone to that chest, and the wood should be sent. Oh no, wait. It should not be sent, because I took all the wood out. Haha, that makes sense. Now it should be sent. There we go. Pretty awesome. So, that's pretty much the whole idea of the quicksort module. Being able to sort items when there is at least one or of the item that you want to have sorted in the designated inventory. But then there is my preferred option, which is the extraction module, which will pretty much take out the items of the chest. Nonetheless, if there's any items already designated, it just takes like, is there space there? Yes, it does. Let's just send it out. So, I will quickly replace this with the extractor module. And you will see that if I would, for this main demonstration, just put the wood planks in here, it would just automatically be sent to the same one. Because the polymorphic item sync says that you can only accept items that already have that are already in this chest. So, that makes sense. But what would happen if I would send something that is not in here already? Like, let's say, a stack of grass. It is able to extract it, so it doesn't have space in there. Where does it go? It goes into the default route, which is set up right here in this item sync set to default route. Pretty cool. So any other items that are able to be stored somewhere will be sent into any other location. And as a final resort, being I have nowhere to send it, it will send it to the default route. Then, for the next stage of sorting, I will be talking about the normal item sync modules, because I quickly want just to give you guys a demonstration of what this did first. So right here, I got the pretty much exact same setup as right here, but I got item sync modules in this thing, set up with dirt, stone, and wood. And then again, a basic, unrouted pipe can go here, because I already got a basic pipe right here. So for this purpose, this thing should do pretty much the same. If I would take out the item right here and extract it, you will see it will be sent to the corresponding place, even though this thing does not have at least one of the item in it. Why is that, you might ask? That is because the item sync already has it pre-configured to have up to 9 different items in this. You might say, well, why don't I just always use item sync, I guess? That's a very good reason, because you can only have 9 different items specified. So if you are a person that has, let's say, a bunch of different things connected to the same system, and you want to have everything connected to that be sent into that appropriate location, you might be cutting it short with just 9 different items. That's why polymorphic might be better for you in that case, because it automatically checks anyway if there's that item available, and it will just send it to that location. Pretty awesome. Then again, there are also 3 different speeds where you were able to extract items. That's why there is a Mark 3, a Mark 2, and a Mark 1 module. If you have a big system, I would always recommend you going for a Mark 3 system, because the Mark 1 extracts items, I believe, at around a rate of 1 item every 2 or 3 seconds. The Mark 2 extracts, I believe, 16 items every second, and the Mark 3 just blows through entire stacks at a time. So that's why I would always recommend you go with an extractor module Mark 3. Pretty cool. But pretty much the same situation that we got right here set up, is that every item that we don't want sorted will go into the default route, and everything that we do have specified will go into their designated slot. If I put the extractor module back, that is. There we go. As you can see, the extractor module Mark III is working really fast by sending the items along their appropriate place. Awesome. And then finally, we got ourselves the last demonstration, which will be the mod-based item sync. As you can already guess, like pretty much what the name suggests, is that it will sort according to the mod. Just like polymorphic does on the inventory, normal item sync will do on the normal things, then mod will be based on the mod, of course. So pretty much what you can do is specify what mod the items have to come from to be sorted into the appropriate location. So currently I got set up a thermal expansion, Minecraft, which is just vanilla Minecraft, which is actually recognized as a mod. And then right here I got myself logistics pipes. And then again we got a default route hooked up in case I add stuff that does not belong in any of these three. So if I would dump something from forestry, it's like, yeah, I have no idea what to do with this. Just send it along the default route. So let's just try it out. Stone. We know where that mod is from. Vanilla Minecraft. Dirt. We know that's from Vanilla Minecraft. A crescent hammer. Wait, yeah, that's from Thermal Expansion. Pretty awesome. And then, of course, you can also sort logistics pipe stuff, because this thing will recognize like, oh, yeah, hey, we have something from the logistics pipes mod. Pretty cool. But if I would, for example, get something from Buildcraft Silicon, and put it in here, you will see it is like, nope, no place in there. Send it all the way back to the default route. Pretty awesome. But of course, sending items along the way into the system is just part one of being able to sort them. You most likely also want to be able to request the corresponding items. So let's get talking about that. Alright guys, and with that, I think it will be a good wrapping up point for this episode. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed, but most importantly found it very educational, because that's what this series is mainly about. Like always, if you have any questions, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. And as long as this video is relevant, I will respond to you hopefully as soon as possible for you. Because I, you know, don't like waiting for an answer myself usually either. So yeah, pretty cool. So pretty much next episode, I will be talking about how you are able to request items from the chest that you currently got connected, or any inventory for that matter, just to make your life a lot easier so you don't have to go running around your base everywhere to take them out manually. Because of course you can sort them, but what's the fun in that if you can't take them out again? So that's pretty much it. So thanks for watching guys, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care.